We've been kind of going, starting to go over some armor, the armor of God. And we're going to continue on that because, see, you know, we have to understand that we have a union. We have a communion, a union with God. And He has given us the ability. He has given us the tools that we need in order for us to be prosperous in our lives. You know, if we never understand a lot of the things that God has given us the capability of tapping in, we're never going to be able to operate in the full power and the full authority of the Godhead. You know what I'm saying? So you know what? We need to, you know, not only do you come to church to receive something, but you need to open your Bible up at home and you need to be studying these things on yourself. You know, one thing I do, I hear a powerful message or something somewhere on the radio or something, and I'll take power notes. But then I'll go home and research it myself. Because, see, I understand one thing. If I research it, then I'm going to get it in my spirit. And when I get it in my spirit, then it becomes a reality in my life. Yes? So, see, we got to learn to get on track and do the things the proper way, the way God intends for us to do. Hallelujah. You know, I think, are we cutting out? No? Hallelujah. But, you know, we're in an area, man. I tell you what, I am so thankful. It's hard for me to look. I need to look down so I can see the back people. But anyways, you know, God has sent us. You know what? We've been faithful. God says that if you're faithful in the little, then He's going to be. Then He'll trust us to be faithful in the big. Well, you know what? He just opened the door up and gave us a big, big part of our ministry. You know what? We have been going into the prisons for. Since 02, we have led hundreds and hundreds of people to the Lord since we've been going to church. You know, He's given us a church to operate out of. We've been a church. See, we started in 02. 2010, we started a church. So we're going on 10 years, been a church. And God has given us so much and so many lives. But the cool thing about it is, when you get involved in a church, when you get involved in a ministry, it's okay to come to church and listen. It's okay to come and fill a seat in a pew. But when you get involved in it, is when you see the hand of God moving even in a greater way. Because just like I tell people, you know what helps me? Helping you. That's what helps me. When I reach out and help somebody, that helps me. You know what? I come from a drug addiction life. I come from a violent background. I come from a 1% outlaw motorcycle club history and different things in my life. You know, if you look at my arrest record, it's very violent. But see, by ministering and fellowshipping with everybody else, God has taken the heart that I did once have and He has turned it. He has changed me to where I look. In fact, I don't even look back because, see, God says forget those things of the past. Huh? And call for the higher calling. Amen? So you know what? You know what? God's given us an area now. This is 2020, November 2020, and God has given us a battle zone of our own. You know, this is one thing that I have been praying for several years now, and I said, Father God, give us an area that we could do a lot of work in, because see, we come out of that background, we've come out of those situations that these people are dealing with. So we know how to approach them. We know how to confront them. We're not scared. We're going to confront them head on, and we're going to minister the Word of God. We're going to see the Holy Spirit operating through us and anointing them, changing their lives. Hallelujah. Why? Why? Because He did it to us. That's the reason why we're able to go and do the things that we're able to do. Huh? I mean, I can't go and talk to people with $500,000 suits on, three-piece suits and stuff like that. I don't speak their language. But you know what? Break out the mirror, get the straw, put a line of dope down. I can tell you how to make the dope because I used to make the dope. I can tell you so many things about that lifestyle. That's the reason why God sent us in this area so that we can minister to the people that are out there. Okay? I have prayed and I have prayed and I have prayed. Father God, give us an area that we can do the best for You. You know what? The devil has taken too many people's lives in this area. You know what? And we are putting him on notice today that he has no more power, no more authority over these people, because the power of the living God, the power of the Lord Jesus Christ has come to this area, and we're going to take it back for him. Why? Because he has given us the ability to do so. He has anointed his people. I don't look at just born-again children of God, but what I see is men and women of power. I see an army being built in this area that we're going to take back. The devil has had too much authority here for too long, and we're going to take it back. That's the reason why I have been praying, Father God, give us an area that we can win for you. I want an area that's got violence. I want an area that's drug addiction. I want an area that families are separated. All these things I've been saying just now, all the things I said just now, is not God's plans. Has never been God's plans. His plans was to unite people in matrimony to stay together for the rest of their lives. His plans were to bring them children up in the ways of the Lord so that they can make a difference when they grow up. Okay? His plans was for us to prosper so that the world can see that he is good, that he takes care of his people. So see, we got that. He says we can walk in divine health. You know, this is one thing that I have said since I've been born again. There got to be more than just being a Christian. There's got to be more to being a Christian, you know, a Christianity than just going to church and saying hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's got to be more, people. You know? But see, the thing about it is, if you'll press into the Word of God and not just stay in certain areas of it, and you open your horizon and open your visions up, and you're going to see that there is so much that God has to offer. Do you know that you can walk in divine health? Our pastor preached that in 2002 when I started church. 2002. It's 2020 now, 18 years ago. Do you know, when I got a hold of that message, I have walked in divine health ever since. I do not get sick that tries to attack me. I have come up with fevers. I have come up with not feeling very good. And then I end up telling the devil he's a liar. Because he is. Right. See, if we're born again, you have to understand one thing. If you are a born again child of God, that sinful nature, that spirit that used to be in you, is no longer in you no more. Sickness and disease does not belong to you no more. You have a new creative spirit, a spirit that came from heaven, and he says, my authority, the heavenly authority, belongs to you now. So we need to learn to operate in the authority that God says his kingdom is able to operate in. Yeah? Yeah. So we need to focus on these things and not being defeated. See, that's where the devil, this is where the devil tricks us and traps us. You know, he wants us to focus on the negative things of life. Because see, without faith, it's impossible to please God, is it not? You have to have faith in order to please God. Hallelujah. And you know what? We're going to have that because we're going to teach it for one thing. We've been teaching it already. We're going to teach more of it. But we're going to teach more on the armor of God. I think God's bringing us over here because, see, we have to have the armor. We've got to put the full armor of God all the way down to our shoes. Huh? From the helmet to the shoes. We've got to put on the full armor of God in order for us to combat and do the things that we need to do. The armor that we give is an offensive armor, and it is a defensive armor too. It works both ways. It protects us, and we are the warrior in it. We are the aggressor in it. We have the weapons that we are able to accomplish the thing, just like the sword. What is the sword? Yes, the Word of God. Hallelujah. God given us his Word that we can go and speak to these mountains and command them to be gone, and they will be gone. Yes. What is your authority? I mean, come on. I'm talking to some of you out here, I know. I'm talking to some of you because, see, you'll allow the worldly authority to control your life, to dictate what's going to happen in your life when it don't have authority. If it has authority over your life, then you need to check and see about becoming a born-again child of God. Because when you receive Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, guess what? You're taking the old authority out to cleaning house, and you're putting God's authority on the inside. Hallelujah. So then we don't have to put up with those things that we normally did and used to do. Huh? Yeah. Hallelujah. I you know what? I just wanted to come here this morning and just share with everybody that we're in a war zone. Yeah. And we're warriors. We're warriors for God. And you know what? We need everybody in church. We need everybody. We're going to do some classes. We're going to start some classes up. And I want people to go to these classes. I don't want you just to say, well, I'll do it later on. No, I want you to go to these classes because we're going to start hitting the streets out here. And we're going to start bringing people in from the streets in here. And then reason why you need to know what you're talking about so that you can teach them what you're living. Huh? Is it important? It is so important that we're able to do these things. Amen? You know, man, I tell you what, if I walk around and struggling paying bills, if I'm walking around and, man, I don't even have food to eat, something's wrong. Something's wrong with my relationship with God. Huh? You know what? I have not tapped into the life of prosperity. I have not tapped into what the Word says. See, we have to understand that the Word of God carries authority. The Word of God carries power. Huh? And when we speak it, when we use it, then we're able to be blessed from it. Hallelujah. Isn't that exciting? Yeah. Yes. You know what? We have so many people come to this church, in and out of church. We've had so many salvations, and today we still get to hear people's lives. They call us Oklahoma City, up in Enid, some out of state, still serving God, still doing good. That's what I'm talking about, because we're making a difference. And that's the reason why the devil don't like what we do. He does not like what we do because we win souls, and we teach people the Word of God. He doesn't like that. He doesn't mind if you say, Jesus, I believe in you, and still continue living your life the way you live. He doesn't mind that a bit. In fact, he kind of likes it. You know, because now he says, I'm taking advantage of my father. Huh? I'm taking advantage of daddy. You know, what? But he ain't. See? Because, see, when you truly open your heart up, and you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, it stops right then, because that new spirit's not going to let you continue going down that path. Right. Yeah. Hallelujah. Rick, come up here, bro, man. Hallelujah. This is another brother of ours. He's coming to this. He's going to change over here, start coming to our church pretty quick. I'm going to let him share a little bit. Better watch out, because he's a ball of fire. Yeah, come up here, Marty. This is his wife. Come on, get up here. Hey, this is all family, okay? Woo! Come on. Yeah. Woo! Hallelujah. Don't act shy. But anyways, I want him to share a little bit with you, okay? He called me up and he said, excuse me. He called me up and he said, man, you know what? I want that area. I want to work in that area. He goes, man, we need to do something here. You know, he says, I want to come here and be part of it. See, this is what God's going to be doing. See, this is all God's thing. You know what I'm saying? He gave us a building that's beautiful. It needed a lot of work. It still needs a lot of work. But it's ours. And we're going to be here for a long time. Go ahead, brother. Take it away. Hallelujah.
Hey, hello, family. It's good to be here today. Well, James was talking on that spiritual warfare. I'm here to tell you, as a new believer, this is the most important area that we need to work on. Tony Evans said, if all you see is what you can see, you haven't seen all there is to be seen. Come on.
That's right.
God deposited inside of each and every one of you a seed of righteousness, a seed of hope,
A seed of peace. I don't need that. He deposited in with you every spiritual blessing under the sun. When a lady becomes pregnant, that embryo, she has to nurture that embryo. She has to feed it. She has to take care of it. And eventually that embryo grows inside of her. Well, the same thing when God deposited in with you the Holy Spirit. You had to nurture that Holy Spirit. God said that you have to build your faith by reading His Word. Faith is what moves the mountains in your life. Yeah. So when you nurture that seed, eventually it rises up inside of you. And then you get this renewing of the mind. We take those old thoughts and they're cast away because we're not feeding them anymore. We're feeding the righteous side of life, and we're able to walk in that righteousness. The armor battle that we put on, it all starts right here with the belt of truth. The truth is God's definition Woo! Of the word. Come on. And in that truth, we can walk in all righteousness as it covers our breast, and that covers the vital organs. When you have the truth and righteousness, they work hand in hand together, and the righteousness is just you as believers making right decisions every day with the thoughts that are planted in your mind. Take those thoughts captive, arrest them, evaluate them, and then walk in the righteousness which is truth. When you do that, you got peace upon your feet. When the world's coming at you and you've got strife and you've got the enemy coming at you, you know the Roman soldiers' boots, they had little spikes in them. And when it come time for battle, they dug in. Well, God said He planted you on solid ground that you may not. He said, stand firm. Stand firm against the enemy. Come on. Church, I love you. We've got so much to do together. We've got an area out there. And today I declare war against the enemy because he's under our feet. He has no power. He has no teeth. He has no bite or might. We have authority over him. And when you take the word of God, which is your sword, you slash him right, you slash him left. And he runs away in terror because he's allergic to the word of God. So get that word deep down inside your souls, church. I love you. God bless you. And thank you for having me and my family here today.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Anybody else got something they want to say? Huh? Come on, Connie. Get up here and say something, huh? Come on. Heck yeah. I'll bring the mic to you. How's that? Hallelujah. I know you've been with us and we've been doing some combating together. Hallelujah.
I love the Lord. For 72 years, my mother gave birth to two other children, and she relied on other people to raise them to love the Lord. And when I was born, 18 years after my sister, she said, Lord, this one's yours. And she raised me. She went to church with me and took me to church and taught me who the Lord Jesus Christ was. And so today, I am standing on the word. I am covered with the shield of the sword of the Spirit and the shield of faith and the breastplate of righteousness and the belt of truth. And I am a soldier of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
I am so excited about this church that I cannot hardly stand it. I mean, do you know, I was with them when they were in Prattville doing prison ministry. My husband and I have been with them all through all of this. And, you know, I have seen so much. You know, we used to feed the women and the homeless and anybody else that wanted to come to church on Friday and Saturday night. We made huge meals. We fed probably at least 100 people every Friday and Saturday night before our services or classes. So I have seen this ministry, and it is good ground to sow into. And I'm so pleased that God put me here with them, that I might be a help to them in any way that I can. And I am so excited because I'm so tired of every building that they've had to have, that they just did everything, made it better. But it wasn't ours. This is what God has for us, and we have it. It's ours. Nobody's ever going to say, I'm sorry, your time's up. You got to go, you got to move out because we need this for such and such. No, God is faithful. And you know, we've been faithful, but you know, in your life, if you're not faithful, God's always faithful. It doesn't matter. Sometimes we think, well, you know, we don't deserve this because we're not faithful. Well, you know, God is faithful. He is faithful that promised. And he loves each and every one of us. And he's got a part. All of us have a part to play. You know, we're going to need help with counseling, ministry at the altar. We're going to need children's workers, which I know I'm going to be one of them. I was in children's ministry for 10 years, and I'm going back. I'm coming. Hallelujah. Quickly. So anyway, and I have a big praise report. A lot of you know that I have been attacked with a lot of sickness and health issues this year. Since May, I have had all kinds of stuff. And I just want you to know that my back is the healed of the Lord. I'm telling you, I feel like I turned a corner on Wednesday, and I am strong. My back is strong, and I'm telling you, I am the healed of the Lord. And my mind, which was attacked with that metabolic cerebral encephalopathy, is under my feet, and there is nothing wrong with my brain. It's perfect. God made it that way, and that's the way it is. Okay, because I got to have my brains, because I got to be smarter than these kids, right? Okay, I love all you guys, and thank you very much, James.
All right. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Okay, good morning. Y'all know my name's Dave, and ditto on all of that everybody said. This is, if you're new, this is a wonderful bunch of people that love Jesus and want to change the world for the Lord. And that's exactly what we're going to do with this neighborhood. We're going to turn this neighborhood around. We're going to take it away from the devil. We're going to kick the devil's hiney and keep him under our feet. And one of the ways we're going to do that is we have a class that we teach. And we just started over again last Thursday night. And we'll continue every Thursday night unless we change the night. That's going to teach healing. The name of the class is Divine Healing Technician. And if you take this class and you do what you learn, you will be able to lay hands on the sick and they will recover. No ifs, ands, or buts. And I mean, it works. I could tell you, if Pastor will give me 20 more minutes, I got some more testimonies. No, maybe not. Another time I'll tell you some testimonies. Come to the class Thursday night, 7 o'clock, right back there. All right. Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you, Lord.
Hey, everyone. I woke up this morning. God put something on my heart. I believe he wanted me to come here and speak to the church. I want to say, first of all, this ain't about politics, okay? Me and my wife, we watch a channel. It's called the Victory Channel. Some of y'all have it, some of you may not. We watch a program called American Stands. Who believes a pathetic word is from God? Who believes in that? It is of God, right? Bible teaches it. Okay. Two prophetic words. This is just two. There's been many. Many prophetic words speak about this. And I say again, this ain't about politics. It's not about Democrat. It's not about Republican. It's about God.
Come on.
First one, Hank Kuhneman, very anointed man. This is what he said.
Come on.
Don't look at the polls. Don't look at the media. The polls, the media, the procrastinating. My will be done. I've made my choice. I've made my vote. My man will stand in the land again. Again. This is not about politics, folks. This is about evil and good. We are fighting spiritual forces right now. Spiritual forces. Another man, George Pearson, said he heard from God. He saw God. God says, I am angered. I am angered. Satan, you have messed with my people. There's a lot of corruption going on. He said he's done. George Pearson said he's seen God do this. You messed with my man, my choice. And again, please, I'm not trying to switch anybody politic. He said his man is Donald J. Trump. Now, I say this. If God's prophesying over this, what is that saying to y'all? What is that saying to y'all? Don't mess with God. Don't look at what's going on in this world right now. We're fighting evil. America's under attack. This is terrorism. You know? It says Biden has won. Okay. Whatever. You know? But what hurts me is when I look on Facebook and I see so many church leaders, so many people in this church has already said, he's won. What can we do? Pray. You know, God's saying, pray, pray. You know, believe in God. He's saying it's not over yet. You know, and again, like I said, this is not about politics. It's not about Republican. Love Donald Trump, hate Donald Trump. I don't care. Sometimes, you know, I'm a Trump supporter, straight up. I'm not trying to say, don't say GRC is trying to switch me from whatever. That's not what's going on here. I'm just here, you know, God told me to come and speak to you guys about what's going on spiritually. You know, it tells us we're going to have these. It tells us that we're going to have to fight against spirits, you know, of evil. And that's what this is. It's the spirit of evil. You know, when God gets up here and says, this is my man, that's it. He rolls up his sleeve. He said, he's done. He said, watch me work. So, you know, I mean, there's a lot of Christians sitting here already saying, it's done. What can we do? Pray. You know, and you're saying, well, we'll pray now that when Biden gets in office. You know what? When you go talking to God about after Biden gets in office, he's going to tell you this. Where was you when I asked you to pray against evil? You know, if you don't think this is evil, look at the situations. These people are believing in late-term delivery abortions. That means pulling a baby out of the womb, killing it. You think that's of God? No. Right. Now, people, again, you know, don't take this as politics. Look at it as evil. Yes, Miss Miller.
Doesn't the word say, every place you lay your hand to, you shall prosper?
Exactly.
Did you lay your hand to it?
Me? Oh, yeah, I've been, yeah. Yes. Expect, that's what I'm telling everybody in here. You know, if you're going to pray, believe it, it's happening. Exactly. Hank Kinman was talking about that right there. He says, how many times in the Bible has God intervened when everybody's, like, all hopes are down? You know, Daniel, Israel, you know, the guys in the furnace. God's been there. God's intervening. And that's what I'm here to tell y'all. You know, whatever side you want, Democrat, Republican, I don't care. You know, it's not about that now. This nation is under attack. And all of us as Christians, American Christians, need to stand to believe that corruption will be undone. Will be exposed. All lies will be brought to the surface. You know, God puts men in, he puts the presidents there. And I believe God's trying to put this president back in there for a reason. And like I said, again, it's not about politics. It's not about Democrat. It's not about Republican. It's about what us as an American Christian should be doing. You know, if you're an American Christian, you're saying it's okay for this man to get in here, kill babies, and do all this other evil stuff, then you need to get a check with God. There's nowhere in the Bible does it say killing a baby is okay. So. There you go. That was brought up today. Amen. Amen. One more thing, and I'm going to pray, and then I'm out. Hank Kinneman says, please, people, Christians, don't give up. Don't give up. This is where we need to hit our knees the most and start praying. You know, praying against this Biden Satan. You know, just, yeah. You know what you need to do if you're a Christian. You know what y'all need to do. Standing, yeah. Father God, we come before you today, Father God. Father God, we don't come before you not as a Republican, not as a Democrat, Father God, but as a Christian of America, Father God. But Father God, we come before you right now with this election, Father God. Father God, we just thank you that your will be done in this election, Father God. Corruption is brought to the surface, Father God. Everything is going to come out and be exposed as it's supposed to, Father God. Just as you said, watch you work, Father God. And Father God, we just give you the praise and the glory for that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
My turn. I just want to say I'm very proud of that young man right there. You know what? A year ago, he wouldn't have got up here and done that. He is so on fire for God now. And our little friend back here, Livewire is his road name. And what do y'all think? Does it fit? Yeah. You got Debbie, mighty woman of God. She is a prayer warrior. I will guarantee it. We have Connie with us, another one. I call her on the phone and I say, I need prayer for this. And she hits her knees. She's praying. She's standing in the gap for anybody. You got Ann. Ann's the same way. Pray. Give me a prayer and watch me pray. Miss Millie is willing to pray. Dave is. We have prayer warriors in this church. And this neighborhood around here has no idea what they're getting into now. You know, I could name several other people. I don't mean to leave anyone out, but I'm saying just look at the handful of people. You know what? We're strong as long as we're united with Christ. We're powerful as long as we believe what we say is going to move mountains out of our ways. You know what? I speak to drug dealers in this neighborhood and I say, bye-bye. You're out. Worrying. Here we are. Hear us roar and watch our God do mighty things.
Hallelujah.
We're here. I also want to say we do have a children's service, but we're not prepared this Sunday. Next Sunday we will be, Jennifer, if you'll give us another week, we have a place for the children. You know what? We got to train the children up in the way that they should go. So when they are old, they will not depart. We need our children to know what the Word of God is saying. We got to teach them what the Word of God is saying. You know, some parents, they won't talk about God. They'll never tell their parent, but you know, or their child about Him. But you know what they'll do? Put them on a bus and send them to Sunday school. So we're going to need workers. We're going to need workers like we've never needed before. You know what? It is harvest time. The fields are white here in this area, and we need to go out and make a difference. We need to be the body of Christ and let Him use our hands, our feet, our mouths. Here I am, God. Send me. Amen. And I want everybody in this church to know that you're a part of everything that goes on in this church. If you come to this church, you pay your tithes, you're a prayer, you're helping out here with all this remodel, everybody has a part to do. I just want to encourage everybody, step up and do your part. You stronger, man, imagine how strong our body would be, our mouth would be, our hearts would be, the love that God could build in us if we all stood as one. One accord. Amen.
Hi, guys. My name is Maudie, and I'm Felix. He just talked earlier. I'm his wife, and I'm over the children's ministry, and I've been in prayer and fasting for a long time about what to do and how to do whenever we get over here. And we are going to have warriors in training. And we're going to teach these kids how to go home and set their homes on fire with Jesus. And bring mama and daddy in. My heart's tender for these kids. And I'm excited to see what's going to happen because God is going to do great things here. And my husband and I, when we were walking around the neighborhood, we were casting Satan out. And we told him it was time for him to go because God's moving in. So we need to get ready. There's work to do, and we need to do the work. Okay?
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Well, that's just a few of our people here. Mighty warriors for God. You know, you just heard their hearts. Huh? You just heard their desires and their compassions and things, and that's to reach the lost. That's to help the Lord change the count from him to from this one to that one. Amen? Yeah. Yeah. And that's exactly what we're going to do. You know, I am so excited about this. I've been in prayer. I've been working so hard here lately, I've been slacking on my prayer. But, you know, I'm just excited of what God's fixing to do. You know, what we're fixing to go into. I'm excited about that. I don't know the plans of God yet. I don't know. But I know one thing. He says, bring them up. Bring them up so that they can do the work for the ministry. Yes, and that's what we're going to be doing. You know, just like my brother got up here and spoke a while ago, Rick Livewire, you know, he teaches classes and stuff like that, so him and his wife, they're already prepared. You know, they're ready to do some combat. They're ready to fight, you know. Hallelujah, and we got so many people. We got Marty and Deb. There's so many people in this church. All we got to do is start bringing them in. Start bringing them in, and their lives are going to change. You know, that's the cool thing about it is you get to see the transformation right in front of your eyes of what they were once, but what they're becoming today. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Isn't that awesome?